Hello, Talia. Hello, Carolyn.
Hi.
It's a great pleasure to have you here answering some questions with me today. I will ask you just a few questions about your visit here, the school, the program that you are doing here, and just your thoughts about Italy and Italians. Okay?
Yes.
Cool. So, what's your age and where do you come from?
I'm 20 years old, and I'm originally from Long Island, New York.
Great. You, Caroline?
I'm 19 years old, and I'm from outside of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Great. So, can you explain us very briefly what is Global Teaching Lab, actually?
Yeah, so Global Teaching Labs is a program created by MIT, and every year students can apply to three countries, and MIT places these students in a country, usually with a host family, and the student is able to teach some sort of subject for 3 to 4 weeks in that country.
It's supposed to be a good experience for MIT students to have like a better understanding of a culture in a different country, and then it's supposed to be helpful for the students in the school to learn lessons in English.
Great. Okay, so what are you teaching or trying to teach here in Cannizzaro?
So I'm teaching two subjects. To the older students, I'm teaching them machine learning. And to the younger students, I'm teaching Python and algorithms.
Wait, you, Caroline?
I'm teaching chemistry, specifically like fermentation and distillation.
Wait, very interesting. So, are Italian high schools very different from American ones? Or
yeah.
Yes, yeah. Very different.
Okay, can you explain us the main differences between them?
Yeah, so American high schools give a lot of options each year to the students for what classes they want to take. So you can sign up for any classes that you like, which means that you're not normally with the same group of people for 5 years. You move around a lot. And if your interests change, it's kind of easy to change your classes to fit your interests.
Okay.
We also have a lot of differentiation in class levels. So you can take classes that you're more comfortable with at a higher level and topics that you struggle with at a lower level. And this allows students to differentiate themselves by the time they graduate for college applications. I will say, in terms of like students and personalities, high schools are very similar in America, in Great. Terms of like the kids.
Okay, sure. What did you expect from this experience?
So going into the experience, I was a little bit nervous because I had never taught formally in a classroom before. So I think I was expecting teaching to be a bit more difficult than it was. I also was expecting to have a really great time because I heard good things about Italians. And I think the opportunity to live with a host family when you go abroad is really great because you get to know the people from the country really well. So I was kind of expecting that I would get to know many people and make good relationships.
So you didn't have surprised by anything or just nothing shocked you?
I mean, I think the schools surprised me a little bit because I didn't realize how different Italian schools were in terms of structure compared to American schools. Besides that, no, I think a lot of it was kind of how I expected it to be.
Oh, great. So, is the same for you, Caroline?
Yeah, I agree with Talia, like, completely. I wasn't too nervous about the teaching part. I like taught a lot in the past, and I was pretty excited to come to Italy. And we heard a lot about experiences from past students, so I was pretty like comfortable with the situation we were going into. But yeah, I've liked everything here, and there was some differences in just like what we just talked about with high schools in America versus high schools in Italy, but I expected there to be differences.
Great, thank you. So, what will you do after you're graduating at MIT? The hard question of the day.
I'm not really sure yet. So maybe I'll go into finance and trading. Maybe I will go to grad school and do something more concerning robotics. Part of me is thinking about becoming a lawyer and going to law school. Yeah. So there's a lot of options
okay,
here.
Cool. Okay, that's great. Hey, you, Helen.
I'm studying chemical engineering, and I plan to go into industry after graduation. So either I'll go into the oil and gas industry, or I'll go into the pharmaceutical industry. So it kind of depends how my internship experiences go.
Right, sure. Okay, now a few questions about Italy and Italians. First of all, why did you choose Italy?
The food.
Yeah. Okay, apart from that, maybe just something, some Italian quality that you were looking for.
There's just a lot of beautiful cities in Italy. So I felt like, I mean, I only had like 3 weekends to really travel during the program, but there was just an endless amount of possibilities of where to go. Mm-hmm. And I think, unlike some of the other European countries I've been to, I feel that all of the cities in Italy are very like diverse from each other and very unique. So going to a new city is kind of like almost entering a different country. So I was really excited about traveling within Italy.
Thank you.
I have not traveled a lot, so this is my first time in Europe, and I've just always wanted to come to Italy just because the food and the people, and both my parents really love it. And so when I had the opportunity to come to Italy, it was my first choice.
Okay, so you're not disappointed by Italy?
No, not at all.
Okay, that makes me happy. So, and what do you think about Italians? So maybe your hosts and the people you met here.
They're very proud of their food. Rightfully
yeah,
so. It is very good.
Yeah.
But it's like food is like very important in Italian culture. I think a lot more than it is important in American culture.
Yeah, maybe. Yes. We're very focused on what we eat and can we show the entire world that we're eating properly? But it's okay.
Also, I think the people are just very, very friendly. Everyone is very welcoming. I don't know, people don't look down at you for not being Italian.
Mm-hmm.
People are always very happy to speak to you and speak English with you if you don't understand Italian, which is really nice. Right.
Yeah, I also found everyone to be very welcoming. My host family is great, and I thought it was really cool how they just like let me join all of their things as a family, so like family dinners, because that was really special to me and honestly one of my favorite parts of being in Italy. And then the students at school have also been great and like offering to show me around and helping me out with things, which I can't say that students at MIT or at my high school would act in the same way.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So give me 5 pros and 5 cons about Italians.
Pros.
Yeah, food. Let's start with pros.
Food. Very welcoming. Fashionable.
Oh, yes.
Yes,
fashionable.
Very fashionable.
I like how much time families spend with each other. Like, dinners here can go on for 1 to 2 hours.
Yeah.
Normally in America, I had dinner with my family maybe like twice a week. Mm-hmm. So family is really important, which I really like.
Yeah, I like that a lot too. And like the accessibility of everything in Italy. Mm-hmm. Like trains to get everywhere.
Yes, sure. Yeah, perfect. Okay, now the cons.
Oh, boy. Well, Talia and I have noticed one thing, which is that everything in Italy is the best thing.
Sure it
is. Which a lot of it is.
Okay, maybe it's definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yes, we're very proud of
ourselves. Yeah, yeah, which is good. Good to be proud.
Dang.
Okay, maybe something that I found a little difficult, at least teaching, was because the classes aren't split up by level and ability.
Mm-hmm.
It's often, I feel like I'm either leaving out the kids who are really passionate about the material because I go very slow, or I'm leaving out the kids who are not understanding much because I have to teach to the middle.
Mm-hmm.
So that was a little bit difficult for me in terms of education, because I think some people aren't benefiting as much as others.
Okay, same for you?
Yeah, I found the same thing in my classes that I taught 6 different classes, and some of my classes were super motivated and really excelled in what we were learning, and others just really struggled and couldn't seem to focus at all. So I find that the classes that have a like more majority of people who don't put as much time into their studies kind of get weighed down by those people. which I think is unfortunate because I know that there's really talented kids and kids who care a lot in those classes, but they have to stay with the same kids.
Well, thank you for being here and see you at your farewell party tonight, maybe. So thank you so much.
Yeah.